What's up? It's Marco, Sage of Soccer, and the MLS draft just happened, and we got a lot of players to talk about, a lot of talented guys entering the MLS, so I wanted to go through some of the players I'm most excited about. And just letting you know, this is a video from a U.S. men's national team perspective, guys who I think have the ability to break into that squad rather than how they'll do at the MLS level. If you want to see a video about that, this guy, Draft Utopia, go to his website, great breakdowns there, but this is just for a U.S. men's national team perspective. So with that out of the way, let's get into it. So starting things off, we got Ben Bender, the number one pick in the draft, the first draft pick by Charlotte and their new team. He's a midfielder out of Maryland, and honestly, at a collegiate level, he was everything you want out of a midfielder. He had the defensive work rate and ability, passing, a dribbling, taking on players, finishing. Now, all the skills that you need to succeed at that eight position, he was doing very well there. The questions are, how good are those skills translated to a higher level? I haven't seen him really be forced to use technical ability in like really tight spaces. I haven't seen how his athleticism will do when he's going up against great athletes every single week. So it's tough to see there, but he's got a ton of skills, someone I'm really excited to watch in the MLS. Also, he's left-footed, which is not easy to come by in the USA program. And so I do think he'll get a bit of playing time at Charlotte and someone to look out for. Next, we got Isaiah Parker. He's a winger, well, we'll get to that later, out of St. Louis going to FC Dallas. And man, great athlete, amazing dribbler, good end product, and most importantly, left-footed. We do not get left-footed attackers in this program, so having another one, that's great. There's also been talk of transitioning him from a winger to a fullback. He does have the defensive work rate, and I feel like that could be an interesting idea. So he's a very good player. I feel like he does have the skill set to do well at left back. His crossing is very good as well, and he's a very talented player. And with left back, it's kind of a weak position for the national team. I mean, you have Anthony Robinson, clear number one, but below that, Jonathan Gomez, he's still up in the air if he'll even commit. George Bello, Sam Vines, good but not great players. So that left back position is wide open. And more importantly, going forward, that left-footed attacker is just something we don't have. So you can't have an inverted winger on the right-hand side. We don't have a traditional winger on the left-hand side. Because that, just him being a left-footed player and a great athlete and a really nice prospect, that's something really valuable. And he's somebody, he went to FC Dallas. That's the greatest spot he could land at to develop. They are in need of a left back as well. So definitely somebody to keep an eye out for, Isaiah Parker. Next, we got Kip Keller. He's a center back also out of St. Louis. He's going to Austin FC. And yeah, this guy has all the physical tools to succeed. And that's why he was given a Generation Adidas deal. He's looked very good on the ball at the collegiate level. Again, you have to see how that translates because being good on the ball is not the same at that level as opposed to an international level where you're getting pressed by some of the top players in the nation and from nations. So you have to see how that translates, but he's looking very good. It'll be a battle for playing time at Austin, but someone to definitely look out for. And he's someone I am pretty excited about to watch. Next, we got Eric Santana. He's a right back slash winger out of Pacific, kind of similar to Isaiah Parker's situation. He's going to Atlanta. He was one of the best freshmen in college, and man, he was doing very well at a wing position, but he's been projected as a right back. I see that that's probably where he ends up. His attacking abilities are very good. Great speed, great crossing. It could help him out in a bunch of different teams, a bunch of different formation setups. His defense does need work, but he's a very young player, and I feel like he would work well in a back five. So I'm not sure if he ever hits Sergino Dest, Joe Scaly levels, but he does look very good, and looks like Atlanta have their fullbacks of the future, with Santana being the heir to Brooks Lennon, and if he even moves on, and Caleb Wiley's probably going to come in for George Bello. So that's it for field players with Generation Adidas, guys. I'll get to goalkeepers later, but yeah, now we're going into some players. I got a couple of strikers that I want to talk about. Striker's not the strongest position at the national team level. First, we have Jack Lynn. He's a striker out of Notre Dame going to Orlando. So he's a pretty talented striker. He's got some good measurables. He had some great production in college. 6'2", and his athleticism is very good. Like, extremely physical player. I feel like they bought him to fill that Daryl DK-sized hole they have in Orlando. So yeah, I really like him. And from what I've been reading about him, his technical attribute seems to be like the thing that they're worried about, but in college he looked pretty good on dribbling. His passing looked good. Like, I'm sure that if they were talking about that being an issue, it could be a problem, but I think he looks pretty good, and he's probably the striker that I'm highest on coming out of this draft. Next, we got Kyle Holcomb, striker out of Wake Forest going to Charlotte, and this guy's just a good goal scorer. He'll put the ball in the back of the net given opportunities. And with us having a pretty weak striker pool, if he can get going and get in form, that's something you definitely want to keep an eye out for. I don't think he's a great striker, like someone who's a true prospect like a Ricardo Pepi or anything like that, but man, just a goal scorer, and you need some of those. Next guy I want to talk about is Farai Mutatu out of Michigan State. He's going to LA Galaxy, and this guy's kind of weird to talk about because I'm pretty sure he's USA eligible, but I'm not positive. I think he is, but just keep that in mind. This guy might be the best athlete in the draft. His speed is just off the charts, but production-wise, he wasn't great at a collegiate level, and I don't really see him elevating that level of production in the MLS, let alone a national team, though his speed is great, and if he does hit form, anything's possible, but he is somebody I definitely want to mention just because of his athleticism. Next, we got Simon Becker, a striker out of St. Louis. He's going to Vancouver, and he had a very good season, and he could be a good MLS striker, but I feel like that's his ceiling. He was a strong striker on a good team in a weaker conference. He has goals in him, but I don't feel like he has much more. And he's more of a traditional number nine, somebody who the team has to kind of be built around. So, I don't know. I'm not too sold on him, but he is somebody I definitely want to mention in the striker pool. Next, I want to talk about a couple of center backs, and they're basically all the same story, where they got a couple of really nice traits, but none of them really a complete package, unlike Keller, who I feel like could really succeed, but there are some guys I want to talk about. Ryan Saylor, he's a center back out of Washington, going to Inter Miami. He is a 24 already, I believe. He could be a solid MLS player, but I don't really see him affecting the national team. Not much room for him to grow, but decent athleticism and defensive skills, but I don't feel like he's a complete defender. Then Ahmed Longmire, center back out of UCLA, going to Nashville, kind of similar. He really hasn't played too much. He was injured this year, but there seems to be a consensus that he has the athleticism to translate to the next level, and that's why he's picked high. I honestly didn't get to watch him enough, but he seems like somebody you got to keep an eye on, but I don't believe he'll be great on the ball. It's kind of hard to project him, but he is somebody you got to talk about, and it's a similar story for a lot of players. Lucas Bartlett from St. John's going to FC Dallas. Matt Nocita from Navy. He will have to miss preseason to graduate, but he is going to be able to play. He's not going to have to spend a couple of years abroad like David Robinson or something. He's going to New York Red Bull. Kendall Burks out of Washington going to Chicago Fire. Ian Murphy out of Duke going to Cincinnati. Asai Easley out of Grand Canyon going to Sporting Kansas City. And Philip Quinton out of Notre Dame going to Columbus. And like out of those guys, Lucas Bartlett seems to be the most athletic. Matt Nocita is 6'8". Definitely something you got to keep an eye on, but he has his standout quality. And Ian Murphy's a bit better on the ball. So those are some guys, some center backs you should keep an eye on. I feel like in the MLS for the national team, center backs are them and goalkeepers are the position that can break through a bit more because, well, you can be more talented of a defender without being good on the ball. It's not ideal, but it is something that happens. So I want to mention all those guys. Now, we also have a couple of good fullbacks, some left backs that I want to talk about. Anthony Markinich. His twin is also a prospect. He's going to Cincinnati. They're both out of NYU. Anthony Markinich is going to Colorado. Pretty good going forward, good attacker. Justin Rasmussen out of Grand Canyon going to Portland, and Charlie Ostrom out of Washington going to Chicago. I can't say I project them as great players, but we do need left-footed fullbacks, and we don't really have the left backs. I don't feel like it's a stretch to say that one of those three reaches like a Sam Vines or current George Bell level of player. Some other random players I liked were Callum Johnson. I liked him at Clemson, tidy midfielder. He's going to LA Galaxy. Chris Donovan, I just have to mention him because he's a Philly guy, but a solid striker out of Drexel. Going to Columbus, might be good, don't know. And Michael Knapp, he actually played D3 before joining New York Red Bull 2, was somehow eligible for the draft because rules I'm not too sure about, and he's going to join Austin. So that's it for field players. On to goalkeepers. I've mentioned this before, but I can't really project how goalkeepers will translate. Just basically, I could say they look good at shot stopping, but in terms of on the ball, it's similar to center backs. You can't really judge them because you can't tell how good somebody is by being pressed by college opposition, and you can't even tell bad somebody is by not doing anything, because it might just be in the system where they didn't want the goalkeeper to have the ball at all. So, yeah, with that being said, the top goalkeepers were Roman Celentano out of Indiana. He looked like the best goalkeeper in the league in the draft, so somebody to keep an eye on. He's going to Cincinnati. And you got Patrick Schulte out of St. Louis, 6'5", former USA Youth International, going to Columbus, so definitely somebody to keep an eye on. Then you have Jacob Jackson out of Loyal Maryland, Marymount, I should say, going to New England. Going to be behind Matt Turner. I think there's another goalkeeper he'd be behind. Probably going to be playing with the Revolution 2 team. Will Meyer out of Akron going to Nashville. George Marks out of Clemson. He was great in their NCAA championship win. He's going to Charlotte. And Alex Smear out of North Carolina is going to FC Dallas. So that's it for all the players who I want to talk about who got drafted. I do want to mention quickly that there are a couple other guys who didn't get drafted but are going to be playing professionally. Some homegrown players include Victor Bezerra out of Indiana, who's going to the Chicago Fire. Dylan Tavez out of Washington, who's going to Seattle Sounders. Chris Haggard out of Georgetown. He has a great story if you want to look that up. He's going to Charlotte FC, but because his homegrown rights were traded there from Seattle. Sean Zawadowski, butchered that name, out of Georgetown. He's going to Columbus. And Tega Iko, I've talked about him a little bit before. Great athlete at the strike position. Out of North Carolina, he's going to Portland. And you got guys like Dante Pulvera, who's going abroad, and a lot of players to talk about. I might make another video on them. But yeah, that's it for everybody who's drafted. A lot of fun players. I feel like we have some future stars in there. Isaiah Parker and Ben Bender, Kip Keller. They're definitely three that I'm pretty excited about. And yeah, talk about with these guys. See you.